Hi, my name is Jose, and I'm going to show you three simple queries so you can get started with graph technology in less than 5 minutes. Today, we're going to be using Neo4j browser, which is a very powerful platform. So let's get started. First thing you're going to have to do is hop over to neo4j.com/sandbox and just click the launch the free sandbox button. This would redirect you into a page that will let you start your own blank project. Once you have selected a blank sandbox, you will have to authenticate yourself and click open. This would then prompt the Neo4j browser. This is the Neo4j browser. Off the bat, normally a blank page can be quite daunting, especially when you don't know your way around a platform. But don't worry. In this occasion, we're going to build a friend for us inside Neo4j to help us navigate graph technology. First of all, we're going to create our friend Nick. So we pop in here and just create friend. He's a person. I'm going to set the name of our friend as Nick. And we're going to ask the browser to also return Nick, so we can see him. And voila, this is your first query, and we have now created a node inside Neo4j. Here's our friend Nick to help us as a companion in this journey, and we can click and drag Nick around. You see, Nick is a fan of lots of places that he likes to visit, and he's messaged us to tell us about a new place. So let's do our second query so we can highlight how Nick is sending us a message. We're going to introduce these new square brackets, which represent that Nick is writing something to us, and this is a message that he is sending us through IG. Okay, interesting. We're now also going to set what is the information inside that message. Let's say it was Nick referred to it as, "Hey, Jose," or "Yo, check out this new pizza place." And we're also going to request from the browser to return to us the message. Look at this. Well, interesting. Nick is a node, and the message is also a node inside a graph. The action of Nick writing a message to us, that is an edge, and we're assigning an action to that edge. So you can see how there's a small story that is starting to form inside this example. The next bit we're going to do is make a reference to what Nick was talking about. So the message that Nick sent us was talking about one of Nick's favorite pizza places. So this place is a restaurant. And we're going to name this restaurant Mike's Pizza Place. There we go. Finally, we're also going to ask the browser to return this last piece of information. And so this is our third and final query. And we now have a small little story of how our friend Nick wrote to us a message that we should go and check out Mike's Pizza Place. Notice how we now have three nodes in our graph and two edges. One edge refers to what Nick wrote about in the message. The other edge refers to what the message itself is talking about. So this was a very quick tutorial so you can start to get your hands into graph technology. Stay tuned for more tutorials as we'll dive into more advanced concepts inside Neo4j. Have a great day.